हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कस अबाउट क्रिटिकल अप्रिशिएशन ऑफ द नॉवेल अनटचेबल. ओके, मुल्कराज आनंद इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमिक ह्यूमरस एंड एंटरटेनिंग नॉवलिस्ट ऑफ इंडो एंग्लियन लिटरेचर. इन स्पाइट ऑफ ऑल हिज बिटरनेस एंड अपोजिशन ऑफ द रिच, he possesses comic vision of life. He has the power of portraying the most pathetic scenes in a comic manner which quickly make us realize that evil. Okay, this is why he has become popular not only in Indo-Anglian but in the whole world of fictional literature. The Untouchable is also a popular work because it deals with the age-old problem of class distinctions in Indian society, where the Untouchables are treated hatefully as outcasts. They have always been discarded and treated inhumanly. Such scenes contribute to the immortal popularity of this novel. Okay, first is its humanism. The greatest source of the popularity of this novel is its humanism. It highlights the basic human feelings of sympathy among the readers. Baka is passing his life in great misery and nobody takes care of him. They are living a life worse than the animals. He describes the deplorable condition of the colony. Animal refuge that lay on the outskirts of this little colony and the misery made it an uncongenial place to live in. These people are known as the outcasts, alienated from the society. The tortures in their life are unlimited, and this is why Forrester comments, "No wonder that dirt enters into his soul and he feels himself at moments to be what he is supposed to be." Okay? Next, realism. In fact, realism is the most powerful element of this novel. Anand faithfully represents these underdogs instead of dealing with they are living a life worse than the animals. He describes the deplorable condition of the colony, animal refuge that lay on the outskirts of his little colony and the misery made it an uncongenial place to live in. These people are known as the outcasts, alienated from the society. The tortures in their life are unlimited, and this is why Forrester comments, "No wonder that the dirt enters into his soul and he feels himself at moments to be what he's supposed to be." Next is realism. In fact, realism is the most powerful element of this novel. Anand faithfully represents these underdogs instead of dealing with the aristocratic class. We find them quite like us and portrayed with sympathy and respect due to them as to human beings. Baka goes to the market, but he is treated as if he is some dangerous animals. The moment he is seen on the road, the people start crying, "Keep to the side of the road." He is called a low caste vermin. Nothing escapes from the observation of the novelist. The psychology of Baka is also very touching. He is willing for a comfortable life like the other people in the society. He wishes to enjoy good food, but he is denied all these comforts most inhumanly. One day, he buys some jalebis, but unfortunately, that is a high caste person. By chance, buy some jalebis, but unfortunately touches a high caste person by chance and he is slapped. All his jalebis fall and spread on the road, which evokes our sympathies for him. This sympathetic attitude of the novelist for this unjustly discarded young boy has imparted this novel a worldwide popularity. Okay. Next, the exploitation of the poor. The exploitation of the poor is the basic theme of this novel, which makes it so popular. These outcasts are not simply rejected, whatever their sanctity and purity is in danger. Anand has exposed the hypocrisy of the high caste Hindus. They consider that if an outcast like Baka touches them or their home, they will be polluted, and so they keep them away. Baka tries to climb the stairs of the temple, and the priest and the other people cry frantically. Okay. Polluted, but later on we come to be know their Pandit Kalinath of the same temple has made a mischievous attempt to rape Baka's sister Sohin. Okay. Thus, this sense of so-called purity is nothing but merely a show. We read such scenes repeatedly and are extremely delighted. From place to place, Anand has dropped hints to raise our human emotions, as Forrester says. The sweeper is worse off than a slave. He pollutes others when he touches them. Okay. But he has not simply portrayed the situation, rather he indirectly suggests that solution to these problems as well. At the end of the novel, Baka hears the speech of Gandhi and is deeply impressed by it. The novel ends with Baka thinking of everything he had heard, though he could not understand it all. Next, its characters and their portrayal. The novel is remarkable for its characters and their portrayal. The downtrodden outcast Baka has been delineated most attractively, and he is quite realistic. They are normal beings of the society, and we feel an affinity with them. They are lovely and grand, although weak, but thoroughly Indian. It is said regarding this novel, Baka is a typical representative of untouchable, exemplifying the predicament of not only the so-called Hindus, untouchables, but also of dispossessed men everywhere. This perfection in painting the society and the characters in a natural and realistic mode imparted this novel such a quick popularity. The whole Indian atmosphere, with Hindus performing religious rites, the class distinction, the picture of the temple, and the consciousness of the society, even on the road, have made it a beautiful story. Anand has made his works more and more impressive by making free use of phrases, words, and even Indian adages translated into English. There are words like Jamada, Ram, Le Ram, Kalime, and others. Sometimes there are impressive phrases which create a thoroughly native atmosphere. Son of a pig, bitch, or prostitute. There are other commonly used adages by the low class people. Eater of your master, eater of your husband. In fact, when he is describing something, the language is fine. He realistically shows how people behave in a particular mood. Instead of doctor, he uses the word Hakimji, which quickly attracts our attention. The words like chandal and bhangi takes us to realistic Indian surroundings. So the book remains unrevealed as a work of fiction by an Indian writer. It gained popularity by its force of comedy, pathos, realism and pure Indianism. Okay. Mulkraj Anand's Untouchables was published in 1935. Of all his novels, Untouchables is the most compact and artistically satisfying. It is the shortest of his novels. Still, it is the most classical of his novels, for the unities are remarkably observed. It is the story of a low-caste boy back in the town of Bulashah. The action of the novel covers the events of only one day. Vakha is 18. His father Laka is the head of the sweepers of the town, as well as his father Laka is the head of the sweepers of the town as well as cantonment. He is called the Jamadar, the person who collects all sweepers. Laka has been doing his duty quite sincerely. He has accepted the law of untouchability. But with his son Vakha, it is otherwise. He is a young boy of the 20th century who regards untouchability as a curse to end it. He is ready to struggle fearlessly.